My name is Jerome Holman, and I work in the Windows Devices Group at Microsoft. It's basically a team where we build cool stuff, tablets, phones, things like HoloLens that hopefully will excite and delight customers. Programming languages usually have a few different ways to define and control behavior that should repeat. These are usually called loops. They go by different names in different languages like for loop, while loop, do while loop, for each loop, repeat loop, and so on and so forth. These types of loops have small differences, but all of them are just different ways to get the computer to execute some lines of code repeatedly. Often in programming, we have an algorithm that just needs to repeat a specific number of times, or repeated while some condition holds true. We're going to show you how to use a looping structure called a for loop in JavaScript, and you can find for loops in the control section of the toolbox. It looks like this when you drag it out. A for loop in JavaScript, like this one, is just a type of counter loop. It counts up from 0 to the number you type in. Let's do a little experimentation. You can drag any commands you like inside the for loop block. These commands will be executed over and over for however many times you specify in the loop. When you run the loop, notice the App Lab highlights each line as it executes. Now, why does the for loop block highlight after each iteration of the loop? That's because the for loop needs to check its counter every time to see if it should stop or run the commands inside the loop one more time. One thing to note about loops is that your code will still execute from top to bottom as before. You can put lines of code before the loop if you need to get something set up before the loop starts. Likewise, after the loop is done executing, it will pick up on the line right after the loop. Loops are a powerful programming construct that uses the computer's primary advantage over humans, that being their amazing speed. By repeating commands as many times as we wish, loops allow us to solve new problems at a scale that would be impossible without computers. There is still much to learn about the loop, but the concept is simple. Loops repeat commands as many times as we need. Now you know how to use a simple loop. You can use them in your programs and take advantage of your computer's power and speed.